Okay guys, we're going to continue with the same page that we've been on, but now we're going to learn how to name oxo or oxyacids. First things first, what are the features of an oxy or oxo acid? Well, we have to say that they contain H+. And now the second feature is that they possess a negative polyatomic ion. With oxygen. With oxygen or oxygens. Okay, so that's the defining characteristic of oxo or oxyacids. Here we have a polyatomic ion connected to our H+. That polyatomic ion has one or more oxygens present. Now, what are the names for name? What are the rules for naming these types of acids? Well, we're going to say if the polyatomic ion that's involved in the oxy or oxo acid has ATE as the ending, then we're going to change that ATE ending to ic acid. If the polyatomic ion ends with ite, then we're going to say we change the ite ending to os acid. Os acid. Okay. So again, remembering your polyatomic ions is going to be essential for naming oxo or oxyacids. Without that, it's going to be really difficult.